The president today attacked the story of high-level campaign advisors having frequent communications with Russians known to U.S. intelligence. Those advisors, of course, include Michael Flynn, whom President Trump fired as his national security advisor on Monday night after Flynn was shown to have lied to the public and to the vice president about the contents of his phone call with the Russian ambassador in December.
The issue, pure and simple, came down to a matter of trust. And the president concluded that he no longer had the trust of his national security advisor.
That was White House Press Secretary Sean Spicer on Tuesday. But today, President Trump gave a quite different explanation.
Michael Flynn, General Flynn, is a wonderful man. I think he's been treated very, very unfairly by the media. As I call it, the fake media in many cases.
The media, of course, did not fire General Flynn. President Trump did. Now, what the media did do was revealed to the nation that General Flynn had lied to the country and to the Trump team, including Vice President Pence, when he claimed he never discussed Obama's sanctions on Russia with the Russian ambassador. President Trump knew this at least as early as January 26, but he did not act on this until the media revealed the truth to you and, as it turns out, to Vice President Pence, who learned about it through the media, sources say. The president reacted to this all on Twitter today. Quote, the fake news media is going crazy with their conspiracy theories and blind hatred. MSNBC and CNN are unwatchable. Fox and Friends is great. Of course, these stories in the New York Times, the Washington Post, CNN, and elsewhere are not conspiracy theories. These are news stories sourced by government officials. Conspiracy theories are different. They're false. They're crackpot. They're nonsense. How do I illustrate what a conspiracy theory is? How about this one about Ted Cruz's father?
His father was with Lee Harvey Oswald prior to Oswald's being, shot. I mean, the whole thing is ridiculous. What is this right prior to his being shot? And nobody even brings it up.
That's a conspiracy theory. Or how about this one about President Obama?
I wish he would, because if he doesn't, it's one of the greatest scams in the history of politics and in the history, period. You are not allowed to be a president if you're not born in this country.
Those are conspiracy theories. These are facts, as established by former and current national security and intelligence officials, as President Trump almost seemed to simultaneously acknowledge today.
From intelligence, papers are being leaked, things are being leaked. It's criminal action, criminal act.
Now, no president likes leaks, especially ones that reflect poorly on his administration. But it's worth noting, candidate Trump's path to power was tread on a road of leaks, leaks against Hillary Clinton. Some came from WikiLeaks.
WikiLeaks,
the wonder of WikiLeaks.
WikiLeaks.
WikiLeaks, some new stuff
in WikiLeaks.
And many of the ones about Hillary Clinton's private email server, those leaks came from the FBI. Right before Election Day, in fact, Fox News reported and then had to retract a report based on erroneous leaks that the FBI investigation into the Clinton Foundation was going to likely lead to indictments almost immediately. Now, retraction notwithstanding, candidate Trump, well, he had at it.
The FBI agents say their investigation is likely to yield an indictment.
He didn't have a problem with leaks then. It's worth pointing out, it's not a moral position if you only hold it when it applies to you.